Hi there and welcome back to the Der Grenadier YouTube channel for another video. First of all, I want to wish you all a very happy new year. I hope this year is going to be better than last year, with more events of course. But optimism is always the best, so I'm optimistic for this year and I hope you are too. This is going to be another remake video from the beginning of my channel. This video is going to be about the gas mask canister and its accessories. So we're going to dive right into it. I thank you for watching and I hope that you enjoy. So, what you see here is my personal gas mask setup. First off, the container or the gas mask canister itself. This is a later type, a tall one. You also have models like these with the small one with this reared clasp thing. This would be more suitable for an early war impression. This is not the one that I use. This is the one that I use, so the later war type. We have a few different categories that we're going to go over. We have the container itself with the straps. We have the gasplanetasje with the gas cape. And a leather strap to keep it on, which is not a necessary item because you can put it on the strap itself. But for now we're going to include this with that part of the setup. We have the gas mask itself with its filter, and we have the accessories on the right there. So first off, the canister. So this is an original canister with its original paint. I would prefer an original canister which has been repainted, but I don't have one of those, so this is the one that I use. The straps that I have on here are made by Pantostore, and I did a review on those, so there is a video already on the channel. And I put a name tag from Verlag Kopf on there. I'm very happy with these Pantostore straps. I would suggest you get a pair of these if you don't have proper reproductions. This is the original strap that was on here. I just left it there. It's in fairly good shape, so that's great. On the inside, you have the little door for the glasscheiben, which are over there. And it is stamped with 1942, so it's a very nice canister. In used condition, don't use a mint one if you use an original. Use a nice used one which has a lot of dents and stuff, so you don't ruin it. It's already ruined basically, but don't use a shit reproduction. Use an original canister, preferably repainted. We already did a elaborate video on this. What I'm interested in right now is what's in here, which is a reproduction gasplane. This is a rubberized one, so it's a fairly good reproduction, but nobody's going to see it ever, so that's just for my peace of mind that it's authentic in there. And the strap that I have on here is made by Vincent, so can't go wrong with that. This is the part that everybody sees, so make sure that this is what you put the most effort in, because nobody's going to see this or that, so make sure that this looks good. Now, for the next part, the gas mask itself, there are many different variations that you can get. It doesn't really matter which one you have, as long as it is an original or a close post-war one. This one is also marked 42 all over. And the filter, although probably post-war repainted, is 42 marked. And this is the tall variant. Again, it doesn't matter which variant you have, because there are lots of different variants out there. Originally, this would have a rubber plug right here and a cap that you screw on right here. I don't have those. I just wanted to say that those should be on here, just for good measure. I am looking for those, so if you see a set, please hook me up. This one does have matching tan paint under here, so this was originally a set, I guess, but this has nice tan paint all over, which looks really cool. It might be post-war, I'm not really sure, but it is still an original mask. The rubber is not dried out or anything, so very good condition, which is something that I can appreciate. And it has stamps all over in there, which you can barely see, but they are in there. So, next up are the accessories. So we have the retainer spring for the cleaning cloth that you use for your lenses. These are in the bottom of the gas mask canister. I also have this little manual that I got a long time ago. I don't know how authentic it is, but I have it in there just for show. Two packs of glasscheiben, which go in the little thing in the lid. I don't know another word for it. And we have these weird containers. This is decontaminant for your equipment, like your weapon, when you are hit by gas, of course. And this is, these are tablets that you mix with water and you use these to decontaminate your skin. Usually, I believe you got four of these and one of these. Keep these in your bread bag or in your pocket. If you have just one of this, you know, just for good measure, take one with you, just for show. Now, we are going to look at how all of this fits together. Since all of this is still on here, you know, the gasplanetasje with the gas cape and the straps, we're just going to let that go, because I already show in a video how you're supposed to do that. So we're going to start with the glasscheibe. I have a little name tag in here. I also have one on the strap, but just with the dive rider, I made a little tag. These go under this spring, just like that, and they are, well, put away nicely. It's a little bit overcomplicated, I guess, because why not put them in there just with the mask, but this is typically German. Overcomplicate all the stuff that you do, and it will work just fine, but it's a little bit of wasted material. Next up, in the bottom, you're going to put the glove. And, well, I put this little thing in there as well. And then, you use your retainer spring and force that in there. Again, overcomplicated, but that's the way you are supposed to do it. And then you put, well, just to show you, it's all the way in the bottom. And then you put your gas mask in there. And you close it up. And you put this somewhere in your pockets. And that's, well, the whole thing. It's in there nice and snug. These containers are watertight if they are marked with this D marking, which stands for dicht. And they are watertight, so that's nice. So, as a conclusion, I just want to say that I don't keep a gas mask in my gas mask canister at events at this very moment, because I have other stuff that I want to keep in my gas mask canister, because it needs to be safe. It needs to be water and dust proof, and the gas mask canister is the only item in the kit that I can use for that purpose. Things that I keep in there are my phone, wallet, car keys, but also my original camera, my original light meter and my film rolls, and I can't afford that stuff to get dirty. So I keep that in my gas mask canister, but I am looking for an alternative that I can put in my rucksack that is period authentic and water and dust proof, so I don't have to put that in my gas mask canister, and I can actually take my gas mask with me at events just for that authentic feel. That's going to be all for now. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, subscribe, ask questions. If you have suggestions for video, please mention that as well. So that's going to be all for now. As I said, I hope you have a very nice new year, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.